as a Home Assistant user, you might have noticed that the notifications your automation send you tend to be text only. Well, what if you've got a smart doorbell or a security camera and you want to quickly see what was going on when you had a motion notification, for example? Well, rather than having to open up Home Assistant and find the camera feed or open up your camera app and view its history, wouldn't it be easier if Home Assistant just sent you a photo along with the notification? Well, that's exactly what I'm going to show you how to do in this video. So I'm going to show you this process using my Reolink video doorbell because I've already got it installed and it's easy to use, but you can use any camera feed you like just so long as you've got it working in Home Assistant. So let's talk about your options then. Well, Reolink do actually offer a free rich notification service that gives you 25 images per day using their app. But that only works for the doorbells, and it only works if you have the doorbell configured as a standalone device. I've got mine configured with the Reolink Home Hub to record video centrally, and unfortunately that means I can't make use of their cloud subscription services at the moment. So if, like me, you have a Reolink doorbell that's not cloud connected, or maybe you want to get an image from a normal camera where motion is detected, what else could we do? Well, if you're an iPhone user, then the easiest answer here is just to connect your cameras and doorbell to Apple HomeKit, and providing you have some sort of Apple hub like a HomePod, Apple TV or an iPad that's always powered on at home, then you get rich notifications for free. Use the guide in this video to set that up, and I'll stick a link to that down in the description. But if you don't have an Apple hub, or if you have an Android phone, then the other option is to use Home Assistant, and that's what this tutorial is all about. But there are a few steps you need to take to get that working. The first thing to do is to make sure you have set up external access to Home Assistant. There are many ways to do this, including paying Navucasa a subscription fee, or you can follow my guide in this video that will walk you through a free way to enable this. You need external access enabled for two reasons. Firstly, the Home Assistant app needs to be able to communicate with Home Assistant wherever you are in order to get the notifications. And secondly, the rich notification itself has to be able to read the snapshot image in that notification from your Home Assistant server. Once you have external access set up, step two is to install the Home Assistant app on your devices and sign in. The app is basically what will actually receive the notifications. If you don't have the app installed, then there's nothing to send the notification to. Make sure that you configure the app using the external URL that you set up in the previous step. That'll be a duck DNS address if you followed my guide. So to find the device that we're going to send our notifications to, we go down to Developer Tools and Actions, and we want to filter the actions by notify.mobile_app. Now you'll see here I've got two apps connected. So the first one is my iPhone 14 Pro. So I'm just going to copy this bit of text and I'm going to add that into this text file here. So it's always a good idea to make a note of things in a text editor as you're going, because you're going to need all this later. So let's go back and have another look at the notify.mobile app, and we'll select the Moto G5. Let's copy and paste that again to the text editor. So now I've got two Notify devices all ready to go. Next, we need to make sure that we allow public access to a folder within Home Assistant where we are going to store our snapshot images to use in these notifications. So we've got to install a text editor, and I do this quite a lot in my videos, but you go down to Settings, Add-ons, over to the add-on store, and just look for File Editor, which is just there on the screen. You click on Install, it'll take a couple of minutes, so I'll skip to when it's finished. Okay, so once it's installed, we need to start it by clicking on this Start button here, and then we'll also want to toggle this little option to Show Inside Bar, so it should appear on the left-hand side here to make it really easy to use. Right then, once it's started, we will click on File Editor, and we're going to click on this little Browse File System button at the top, and we're going to open configuration.yaml here, and we're going to look for this little section here that starts with default underscore config. So underneath this first line of default underscore config, we're going to put a couple of extra lines here. Now, you'll notice that this first line starts with two spaces as an indentation, and then it says whitelist underscore external underscore DIRS under colon. I'll put all this config up on my website so you can copy and paste it, so don't worry about remembering it now. But all we're going to be saying here is that anything placed in this www folder can be accessed externally. Okay, and we click on save. And then we're going to have to restart Home Assistant. So we go down to Developer Tools and click on Restart. And we're going to do this yellow one here, Restart Home Assistant. So that'll take a few minutes to all come back online. And of course, you need to make sure Home Assistant is connected to your cameras and doorbells. For Reolink, that is super easy. Mains-powered standalone cameras will usually be automatically detected. Or if you have a Home Hub or MVR, connect Home Assistant to that instead, and all of your cameras and doorbells will appear as devices to use in Home Assistant. So I'm going to find my trigger entity for my doorbell button press, and I do that by going to Settings, Integrations, and I'm going to click on this Reolink one here, and you can see I've got 8 devices. So let's click on that there, and we'll look for my front door doorbell. And if I click on that, it brings up this page here with loads of different entities all connected with the doorbell. So the first thing I'm after is a trigger entity for when the doorbell is pressed, and for Reolink doorbells it's this one here, this visitor one. So if I just click on that there, I can now copy that to the clipboard, and I'm going to paste that into my little text notepad here. Now we also need to find the camera entity that will give us the picture. So back in my doorbell list of entities, in this case it's this one here labeled Fluent. So if I click on that, you can actually see there's a live feed from my doorbell. I'm going to click on the settings, I'm going to copy that to the clipboard, go back over to my notebook, and I'm going to paste that entity ID just there. And now we're ready to start creating our automation, or automations if you want to do this for multiple cameras. Just create a separate automation for each notification that you want. I'm going to show this for a doorbell button press notification, but you can adjust this automation for any trigger you like. Maybe you have a motion sensor and you want to get a photo when that sensor detects motion. Or it could be a smoke detector, or literally anything that will trigger an automation. Right, so let's get started on the automation then. And we do that by going down to Settings, Automations and Scenes. I'm going to click on this blue button in the bottom right hand corner that says Create Automation. We're going to create a new automation, and I'm actually going to click on these three little dots in the top right and edit in YAML. Now, I've pre-written an automation, and this will be up on my website as well, so you can copy and paste that if you want. So I've just copied that to the clipboard. I'm going to paste it over the top of whatever was there. Now you'll notice there's a few little sections here where there's big capital letters, and you need to change all of these values to something else. So let's start off with that trigger entity. Let's go back to my notepad, and the trigger entity is going to be front door doorbell visitor. So let's copy and paste that over the top there. Now we've got the actions, and the first thing it needs to do is take a snapshot from the camera. So we're going to get that camera entity, and it was this one just here. And we're going to customize the file name it creates as well. So where it says file name here, I'm actually going to call that doorbell. And you need to make sure that down here at the bottom, you change that to exactly the same, because this is where you're trying to read the same photo that you've just saved up here. Now we need to choose the device that we're going to notify. So I'm going to start off by notifying my iPhone 14. So let's just replace that notify entity with that one. And then in this notification, you'll notice that there's an external URL here and an external port here. Now those need to be replaced with values for how you access Home Assistant externally. So let me just show you. On mine, I've already set it up using the guide that I told you about earlier. If I click on that, you can see here it's accessible externally. Now, back here, I need to change this to whatever I set up, which in this case is this URL just here. and I'm going to put that there. Now the external port I configured is 8126, and if you followed my guide, yours will probably be the exact same as that. Okay, but what if I wanted to notify two devices? Well, I can copy that bit of config there and I can paste it again underneath. Now if I go back over to my text file, you'll see I've got that second device of the Moto G5, and I can put that there as the second action to notify, and I will click on save. It's already filled in the name of the automation, so we click on rename and we're done. Okay, so it's always a good idea to test your automations, and I've got the two phones here ready to go. So let's click in the three dots in the top right hand corner and click on run actions, and hopefully any second now I should get a notification, if you heard that, to the phone. So there you go, someone is at the door. Is that focusing? There you go, you can see there's the notification with the picture, and that's on Android. So it's a little bit less useful on iPhone because the preview image is tiny, but if I can show you that on camera, you can see there's the notification, and that little tiny icon there is the preview image. Now it works a lot better on Apple Watch because you get the full image, full screen. I don't know if you can see that there, but it's basically full screen on the Apple Watch. Anyway, I hope that you found this useful. I will of course put the configuration I used up on my website so as you can copy and paste it easily, and the link to that will be in the description. Please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for free to see more from me. A massive thank you to my amazing channel members and patrons who are listed here for supporting the channel. If you'd like to support the channel too by becoming a member or a patron, then check out the links down in the description. In return, I'll give you early access to my videos and some bonus content too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.